What's up, guys? Welcome to Taco Tuesdays, where we talk about stuff. Yeah, see what I did there? Taco Bell guy? Yeah, whatever. Anyways, so first off, I want to apologize about the noise. The AC thing is right up there, and it's making quite a bit of noise right now. Don't really want to shut it off. There's other people in the house, blah, 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 all this, all that. Don't want to cause problems with them. Today we're going to talk about great find I found at a garage sale. I'm going to do more of these about great finds I found at garage sales, pawn shops, and things like Goodwill, whatever, as I find good stuff and just want to show you. This one today is about a Sega Genesis I found at a garage sale literally down the street. The whole thing cost me like $3. I know. Model 1 Genesis for $3. That's insane. Now, of course, the guy did not have a power cable, which was part of a problem with it, and it was all kind of greasy and messy. You'll see when I show you one of the controllers here, you can take a look. There's some grease, whatever the hell it is on there. I tried cleaning it, I really did, and most of it came off, but there's still some left. And then it also came with an RF cable for video, and that thing broke the second I plugged it in. I plugged it in, the cable just broke off the adapter part of it that goes into the console, and that just was no bueno. So yeah, basically for the $3, I got a Genesis with almost no working cables, two controllers, and three games. Games, of course, being Mortal Kombat 3, Tecmo Super Bowl, and NFL Sunday Night Football, ESPN NFL's football, something like that. Basically this one, yeah, you see it on screen. So yeah, basically the two controllers it came with, there is one real controller, which you're looking at right now, which actually, well, you know, it works pretty well. Of course, the regular Genesis controller. And the other one is the Competition Pro SG6 controller, which has six buttons, as you can see. Here you go, take a closer look at it. This one's actually pretty good. I like it. The button response is pretty good. It has a turbo mode, which is also sometimes nice and useful. Of course, not to me, because I suck at Mortal Kombat, which is the only game I pretty much played. Now, let's talk about the biggest problems, the lack of cables. The video cable issue I had to resolve by actually going out and buying a video cable. It cost me about $5, I believe, and I bought it from Movie Trading Company. Now, of course, for my power option problem, I happen to have one of these power adapters. You can switch the voltage on. You can see right here, it goes from, I think, 1.5 to 12 volts. Genesis actually puts out 9, as you can see here. The problem is, of course, Genesis takes 1.2 amps of power, and this thing only puts out 600 milliamps. Now, I haven't had a problem so far, but eventually that may cause some problems, you know, with power and stuff like that, so I'm looking to actually get a real one, but I never really played this thing, so it's not really a huge problem for me yet. When I get more games for it, I'm gonna look into getting an actual real power cable replacement. Now, proof that it works, here you go, you can take a look, and yeah, it's me sucking at Mortal Kombat 2 and losing. How the hell did I do that? Now, of course, that's not the only thing I found over at that garage sale. One of the other things I found is this Pokemon Snap for the N64 for $1. Now, I don't have an N64, but, you know, I hear it's a really good game. If I ever end up getting an N64, I'm going to want to play this, so, you know, couldn't pass it up. A few other things I got as well, but those we will talk about in another video. Maybe next week, maybe in the future, we'll see. Alright, so that's pretty much it, guys. The story of my $3, well, technically 9 if you count the other cable, Sega Genesis from a garage sale. Thanks for watching, and I'll see y'all next week.